In Psalm 139, the psalmist writes, "You knit me together in my mother's womb. Thank you for making me so wonderfully complex. Your workmanship is marvelous. You saw me before I was born. Every day of my life was recorded in your book, and every moment was laid out before a single day had passed." You know, very simply, the psalmist recognizes, God, you created me, and God, you have a plan for my life. And it's unique. It's unique to me. Now, I know you know this, but take just a moment to think about this with me. Your fingerprint. Your fingerprint is unique to you. For most of us, this is very common knowledge. But the reality that no one else in the world has the exact same set of ridges and lines that you have on your fingers, that not even identical twins have the same fingerprints, and that your fingerprints stay the same from the day that you're born until the day that you meet Jesus face to face? Well, think about that. That's amazing. And think about what this reveals to us about God. How wildly creative He is. That throughout the trillions of people who've existed, He's formed and fashioned each of us uniquely. He's created us uniquely. And His plan for each of us is unique. See, God is doing something with you that's not like everyone else. And the thief of hope, peace, and joy in life, it's comparison. And comparison runs rampant in the world we live in. But we don't have to be looking for the moments we see in the lives of others in the moments of our own life. You see, here's why. Because what God is doing in your life doesn't have to look exactly like what He's doing in the life of another person. You are unique, and that's a good thing. In fact, that's God's thing. I don't have to have a burning bush experience. That's what God did with a guy named Moses. I don't have to have a taking down Goliath experience in my life. God did that through a guy named David. You see, God is doing something with me that He's not doing with someone who is not me. You know, I have this little magnet hanging in my office. It's an old Irish idiom, and it reads this way: be yourself, everybody else is taken. And I think there's a lot of truth to that little statement, and I think there's so much freedom that comes in recognizing that God is my creator, and He's doing something uniquely in me and through me.